गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू अनदर इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। आई वेलकम मिसेस श्रीदेवी, प्रिंसिपल टीएसएमएस पोडर ऑन टू दिस सेशन। मैडम गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, थैंक यू मैम।
ऑल्कोहल्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री बिकॉज दे कैन बी कन्वर्टेड टू और फ्रॉम मेनी अदर टाइप्स ऑफ कॉम्पाउंड्स। रिएक्शंस विद ऑल्कोहल्स फॉल इनटू टू कैटेगरीज। रिएक्शंस can cleave the R O bond or they can cleave OH bond, right?
Yes,
madam.
Yes ma'am, yes ma'am. It includes the cleavage of R OH and OH bond, ma'am.
Yes ma'am. So in the last session madam has discussed about the preparation methods of preparation in the laboratory and how the alcohols exhibit isomerism. In this class,
yes,
madam will be discussing about the laboratory preparation of alcohols and the properties of alcohols. Madam,
yes,
over to you, madam.
Yes, ma'am.
Please continue.
Thank you, ma'am. Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Good morning, dear students. Once again, welcome you all for the chemistry webinar. And it's a time for the alcohols. In our previous class, we have dealt with the isomerism and also the nomenclature and then the classification. Okay, and then the laboratory methods of preparations of alcohols. And today in my session, I'm going to deal with the commercial methods of preparation of alcohols and also the chemical properties of alcohols. See children, what is an alcohol? The alkyl hydroxy compound is called as a alcohol, R-OH, isn't it? Yes. And then in our previous classes, we have learned how these alcohols are prepared in the laboratory. And then today we are going to learn about the commercial methods of preparation of alcohols. See, what is the meaning of commercial method? See, commercial method means the large scale preparation. See, what is it? The large scale preparation of alcohols. See, then how is it prepared? Let us see now. Okay, so then, see, let us move to the next part of this. Okay, so today I'm going to show you some PPTs, children, right? So we are going to deal with the one minute. Okay. Ma'am, is it visible, ma'am? Ma'am, is it visible? Okay then. Okay, children. So today we are going to learn about the commercial methods of preparation of alcohols. See, the first one is methanol. What is methanol? CH3OH is methanol. So this is also known as wood spirit, and it is produced by the destructive distillation of wood. Okay, so these are the different methods how we can prepare methanol, right? So it is produced by the catalytic hydrogenation of carbon monoxide at high pressure and temperature. And here pressure is also like applied, okay, 200 to 300 atmospheres pressure is applied. And what is the catalyst used here? It is zinc oxide and chromium oxide, right? So methanol is also known as wood spirit. CH3OH is the formula of methanol. How many carbons it contains? It contains one carbon atom. Okay, so as it contains one carbon atom, we call it as meth. And it contains the OH group. So ol, methanol. And then, so it is produced by the catalytic hydrogenation. Hydrogenation means addition of hydrogen. Catalytic hydrogenation means in the presence of a catalyst. What is the catalyst used here? See, the catalyst used here is zinc oxide and chromium oxide. So it is obtained when carbon monoxide is catalytic hydrogenated in the presence of zinc oxide and chromium oxide. 573 to 673 Kelvin at 200 to 300 atmospheres pressure. So we get methyl alcohol, that is methanol. Okay, so then see, this methanol is a colorless liquid. It boils at 337 Kelvin and it is very poisonous in nature. Then ingestion of even small quantities of methanol can cause blindness, and when inhaled in large quantities, it causes even death, right? So then coming to the applications of methanol. This methanol is used as a solvent in paints, okay, and varnishes, and it is mainly used for making formaldehyde. See, what is formaldehyde? HCHO is the formaldehyde. So methanol is a colorless liquid. It boils at 337 Kelvin. It is highly poisonous in nature. So when it is taken in small quantities also, it causes blindness. And when taken in large quantities, it causes even death. And then the applications of this is, it is used as a solvent in paints and varnishes, and mainly it is used for preparing formaldehyde. Okay, then coming to the second compound, ethanol. C2H5OH. See, generally, whenever we call an alcohol, it is nothing but ethanol, that is C2H5OH. Then how is it obtained? It is obtained commercially by the fermentation of sugars, right? See, the sugar is present in molasses. What is molasses? See, let me explain you each and every term here, children. See, molasses is a mother liquid. See, it is the dark brown color syrupy liquid. It is a mother liquor which is obtained after the conversion of sugar into sugarcane. See, sugar is from which sugar is extracted? From sugarcane, isn't it? So molasses is the dark brown color syrupy liquid which is obtained after the crystallization of sugar from sugarcane. Or so fruits such as grapes, they are also converted into glucose and fructose. See, what are all these glucose, fructose? These are nothing but sugars. So they are carbohydrates. What are they? Carbohydrates. And then in the presence of an enzyme, invertase. What is it? Invertase. So let me tell you what is the meaning of this fermentation. Fermentation is a process in which a large complex compound is broken into simple compounds with the help of biocatalyst called enzyme. What is fermentation? Fermentation is a process in which the large complex organic compound is broken into simple compounds with the help of biocatalyst called enzymes. That is called as fermentation. Here, ethyl alcohol is obtained by the fermentation of molasses. What is molasses? Molasses is a mother liquor which is left over after the crystallization of sugar from sugarcane. Okay, so generally, glucose and fructose undergo fermentation in the presence of another enzyme, zymase. And where are these enzymes found? These enzymes are found in yeast. Okay, so let us see the next thing. So this is the fermentation of sugars. Here, C12H22O11 is broken into glucose and fructose in the presence of an enzyme invertase. And then glucose is broken into ethanol, means it is converted into ethanol in the presence of an enzyme zymase. Okay, and then this ethanol is also obtained from starch, means it is prepared on large scale from starch also. Then how is it obtained? This starch means, what is starch? Starch, how can we get starch? It is obtained from grains, food grains, wheat, barley, maize, etc. Isn't it? So for this, water is added and it becomes a starch solution. And then it is converted into glucose. And this glucose is converted into ethanol. And here, carbon dioxide is liberated. Here, an enzyme diastase works on this and it is converted into ethanol. See, whenever you come across through the sugarcane factories in your villages, you can observe the different smell of molasses, right? So it is due to the fermentation process, right? Okay. So then coming to the next one. In winemaking, see, grapes are the sources of sugars and yeast. See, when these grapes ripen, the quantity of sugar increases and yeast grows on the outer skin. When these grapes are crushed, sugar and the enzyme will come in contact and the fermentation process will begin. The fermentation takes place in anaerobic conditions. Anaerobic means in the absence of air, isn't it? Anaerobic means in the absence of air. So, and which is the gas which is liberated here? Carbon dioxide is the gas which is liberated during fermentation. Okay, so which is the gas which is liberated? Carbon dioxide is the gas which is liberated during fermentation. Okay, then coming to the properties of ethanol, the general physical properties. So it is a colorless liquid with a boiling point 351 Kelvin. And this is also used as a solvent in paint industry and in the preparation of large number of carbon compounds. Okay, so when you oxidize this primary alcohols, you get carboxylic acids, isn't it? Then the commercial alcohol is made unfit for drinking by mixing it with some copper sulfate to give it a blue color and pyridine. So pyridine will have a foul smelling, pyridine is a foul smelling liquid, and it is made unfit for drinking purpose by adding these two compounds. And this is called as denaturation. Okay, denaturation of alcohol. So the commercial alcohol is made unfit for drinking by mixing it with some compounds. What are those chemical substances? So the chemicals are copper sulfate and pyridine. And this process is called as denaturation of alcohol. So the process of converting the commercial alcohol into by making it into unfit for drinking purpose is called as denaturation. Right. So then coming to the next one. So I will tell you now by taking the whiteboard, children. Okay. I hope you have understood this. Right. So then let me once again explain you the process of fermentation. So what is molasses? Molasses is the mother liquor. Liquor which is left after the crystallization of sugar from sugarcane. So I will briefly write the important points here. You can just copy them. So fermentation of molasses. Fermentation is a process in which large complex organic compound is broken into simple compounds with the help of biocatalysts called enzymes. So then what is molasses? Molasses is a dark brown color syrupy liquid which is left after the crystallization of sugar from sugarcane. It is a mother liquor. Molasses is the mother liquor. Okay, now see. So it is a dark brown color syrupy liquid. And then it contains 20 to 40% of sucrose, children. Okay, I will show you by means of a flow chart. So it contains 20 to 40% of sucrose. And then it is diluted with water. It is diluted with water. Okay, so that the percentage of sugar in it becomes 10%. So sugar percentage becomes 10% by adding water to this. Okay, hope you are able to understand now. So then what they will do, so they will add sulfuric acid to this such that the pH is maintained to 4. The negative logarithm of H plus ion concentration is called as pH. So what is added to this? Sulfuric acid is added such that the pH is maintained to 4, right? So then ammonium sulfate ammonium sulfate and ammonium phosphate. Ammonium phosphate are added to this. Ammonium phosphate are added. See, for what purpose they are added, I will tell you. Ammonium sulfate and ammonium phosphate. I will write the names also. So ammonium sulfate, okay, ammonium plus 1, okay, sulfate minus 2. So crisscross method, NH4 taken twice, SO4, and ammonium plus 1, phosphate minus 3. So NH4 taken thrice, PO4. Okay, Nana? So ammonium phosphate. So why these are added means they are added as they act as food for yeast cells. Food for yeast cells. So ammonium sulfate and ammonium phosphate are added as they act as food for yeast cells. Food for yeast cells. Okay. Hope you are able to understand this one. Yeast cells. And then now what happens? Let us see. Now this, then yeast cells are added to this. Okay. So yeast cells are added. Yeast cells are added. After that, it is taken in a larger wooden tanks and then it is kept for 2 to 3 days. How many days? 2 to 3 days. And then the temperature is maintained at 30 to 40 degrees. The temperature is maintained at 30 to 40 degrees. So yeast cells are added to this and then it is kept for 2 to 3 days and then the temperature is maintained at 30 to 40 degrees centigrade. Okay. So then now after this, an enzyme, so we'll minimize the screen such that I can write the remaining steps also here. Okay. Right. So the temperature is maintained at 30 to 40 degrees centigrade and yeast cells are added to this and it is kept for 2 to 3 days. After that, what happens is this yeast cells will produce an enzyme invertase and this acts on sucrose C12H22O11. Okay. So what is the enzyme produced here? Invertase. Right, yeast cells will produce the enzyme invertase, which converts the sucrose into glucose and fructose. Okay, Nana? Right. See, they have the same molecular formula, but they are optical isomers. What isomers? Optical isomers. So this is the sucrose. This is the enzyme, and it converts it into glucose and fructose. See, nowadays, less importance is given for this commercial methods of preparation. Previously, you used to get a question for 4 marks from this. Say, write about the fermentation of molasses. Okay? Right. So, glucose and fructose. But I'm not claiming this also. I want to tell about this also. Okay? So, then what happens? Another enzyme by name, zymase. Right? Zymase is produced, which converts the glucose, right, glucose into our ethyl alcohol. See, we are learning about the preparation of ethyl alcohol, isn't it, Nana? Yes. So what is it obtained? Ethyl alcohol, that is ethanol, right, plus carbon dioxide is liberated. See, what is liberated, Nana? Carbon dioxide is liberated. 2 CO2. Okay. So then, yes. So this is the fermentation of molasses. Okay. So then I will explain you quickly. Once again, let us recall this. So this is the fermentation of molasses. Fermentation is a process in which a large complex organic compound is broken into simple compounds with the help of biocatalyst called enzyme. Then, see, molasses is the mother liquor. It is a dark brown color syrupy liquid. It contains 20 to 40% of sucrose. It is diluted with H2O such that the concentration of sugar gets down to 10%. To this, sulfuric acid is added and the pH is maintained at 4. And then ammonium sulfate and ammonium phosphate are added. They act as food for yeast cells. Then yeast cells are added to this and it is kept in large wooden tanks for 2 to 3 days at 30 to 40 degrees centigrade. And then two enzymes are produced, invertase and zymase, by the yeast cells. Invertase acts on sucrose and converts it into glucose and fructose. And then the enzyme zymase acts on glucose and converts it into ethanol and carbon dioxide is liberated. Okay, so this is the fermentation of molasses. Okay, Nana? So now let us move to the properties of alcohols. And then the another preparation you have seen, I have shown you through the PPTs. Okay, so now let us move to the next one, that is the properties of alcohols. See, the properties of alcohols are very important and interesting also, right? Okay, so properties of alcohols. Hope you are all copying the notes. Okay, Nana? So you're all copying down the notes and following our YouTube channel. See, the time is less for your IPE exams. Almost all we are in the last month of this year, 2020, right? So properties of alcohols. Now, alcohols are soluble in water, the first property I want to tell you is. So they are soluble in water. Why they are soluble in water? Right? See, what is the reason? The reason is nothing but they have hydrogen bonding. Many of you might have recalled about this. So they form hydrogen bonding with water. Hydrogen bonding with water. Okay. So what hydrogen bonding? Intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Inter, in between, intermediate. As it is present in between your 10th class, SSC and graduation, it is called as intermediate. Like here, intermolecular. As the bonding is present in between two molecules, in between two molecules, it is called as intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So intermolecular hydrogen bonding, like this. See, this is our ethanol, C2H5OH, isn't it? Now, this is our water molecule, H, okay, and then O, and then H. So in between two molecules, there is a hydrogen bonding. So this pink color line is the hydrogen bond, which is formed in between the partially positively charged the proton and then partially negatively charged oxygen atom. So hydrogen bonding is nothing but the bond present between the hydrogen atom, right? The hydrogen ion, we can say, and then the highly electronegative atoms like oxygen and then fluorine. Okay, so then see here. So ethanol is soluble in H2O because of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, right. So I think now you have understood this. Now let us move to the remaining properties of alcohols. Okay, children. So, and then as Madam said, The properties of alcohols can be classified into two categories, means we can study under two heads. See, the first one is reactions. Please write down, Nana. Reactions, okay, involving the cleavage means breaking, okay, splitting. You can give many number of synonyms, right? Cleavage. So reactions involving the cleavage of, okay, OH bond. What is it? OH bond. 1 minute. OH bond. Okay, right. So reactions involving the cleavage of OH bond. See, what are those reactions? Let us see one by one. So the first one is reaction with active metals like sodium. Reaction with active metals like sodium. So this reaction shows that alcohols are acidic in nature. Okay, so let us see the reaction. C2H5OH, okay, plus Na. What is Na? Sodium metal gives C2H5ONa plus half mole of hydrogen. Okay, so what is this? Ethanol. Okay, and let us go for the different color for the product, right? So this is sodium ethoxide. Very simple. Na is sodium, isn't it? And then what is C2H5O? Ethoxide. Sodium ethoxide. Okay. Sodium ethoxide. So this reaction shows that alcohols are acidic in nature because hydrogen is liberated here. What is liberated, Nana? Hydrogen is liberated. Okay. So then see here. I will write another reaction. So C2H5OH, ethanol plus sodium. How many moles? We will take 2 moles, right? So now let us see the reaction. C2H5ONa, 2 moles, isn't it? Plus hydrogen. That's it. Okay. So this is nothing but sodium ethoxide only. So generally, they form alkoxides. What you should remember here? Alkoxides. So when alcohols reacts with active metals, they form alkoxides. What is it? Alkoxide. As it is ethyl alcohol, we are calling it as sodium ethoxide. Suppose if it is a methanol, we call it as sodium methoxide. And what is liberated? Hydrogen gas is liberated. This shows that alcohols are acidic in nature. I will write this also. Please note down. So this reaction tells us that alcohols are acidic in nature. Alcohols are acidic in nature. Please remember. Alcohols are acidic in nature. Okay. I hope you have understood the first property, right? So these are the reactions which involve the cleavage of OH bond. Now, let us move to the next one. So this is another interesting and important property. So this is nothing but esterification. What is it? Esterification. Esterification. What is esterification? Esterification means formation of esters, right? So this is the second reaction under the first heading, that is reactions involving the cleavage of OH bond. So esterification. Ethanol, C2H5OH. So ethanol reacts with carboxylic acid, acetic acid. I'm taking here acetic acid, CH3COOH, acetic acid, COOH. Okay, and forms, what does it form? It forms an ester, CH3COOC2H5 plus H2O. Okay, so what is the name of this? Ethyl acetate. Okay, ethyl acetate, right? So in the presence of an acid, okay, so we will show here H plus ion. Whenever you see a H plus ion, you should understand that it takes place in acidic medium. Which medium, Nana? Acidic medium, right? So what does it form? It forms ethyl acetate. So ethanol, alcohol, and ethanoic acid. See how many carbons? 2 carbons. So ethanoic acid, what is the common name? The common name is acetic acid. And what is the IUPAC name of this? So what is the IUPAC name? Ethyl ethanoate. Okay, so what is this? This is an ester, R, okay? COOR is an ester, right? So this is esterification. And then let us see what are the remaining reactions also here. Okay, so ethanol C2H5OH. Ethanol reacts with acid chloride, CH3COCl. Now, what does it form? Let us see. So, this is acid chloride, that is acetyl chloride, ethanoyl chloride. Okay, so HCl is eliminated, isn't it? Then what is left here? C2H5, or else we will write like this, CH3, okay? Again, COOC2H5 plus HCl, okay, plus HCl. So let us write the names of this. So this is again our ethanol, that is ethyl alcohol, and this is acetyl chloride, that is acid chloride. What is it? Acid chloride or ethanoyl chloride, because 2 carbons, isn't it? Ethanoyl chloride. See, I'm giving all the names to you children such that it will be very easy. Okay, so what is the name of this? Again, it is ethyl acetate is the common name. What is IUPAC name? Ethyl ethanoate. Okay, Nana? So esterification, what is it? Esterification. So these two are the reactions which involve the cleavage of OH bond, right? So now let us move to the remaining properties of alcohols. I hope you are able to follow me, children. So I think I'm not very fast in my teaching, right? So then the second type of reactions. So the reactions which involve reactions involving the cleavage of, sometimes I may be checking children whether I'm missing right on the board or not. So reactions involving the oxygen bond, okay? Carbon oxygen bond, right? Okay. So now let us see these reactions one by one. Okay. So let us move with the first reaction. So action with PCl5. Phosphorus pentachloride. So what is this? Phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride. Right. So then coming to the next one. So I'll write the equation here. Ethanol reacts with phosphorus pentachloride and forms, what does it form? It forms ethyl chloride, that is C2H5Cl plus POCl3 plus HCl. Okay. So by this time, many of you have identified this reaction. Yes, you have learned this reaction. Where do you learn this? You have learned this reaction in the preparation of ethyl chloride. Very good, right? So then we will write the names of the compounds here mentioned. So this is again our ethanol reacts with phosphorus pentachloride. Penta means how many? Nana, five. So phosphorus pentachloride and forms ethyl chloride is a common name, isn't it? What is the IUPAC name? Yes, chloroethane. Chloroethane. Okay. And phosphoric chloride. Nana, just don't learn the equations, but try to write the statement also. When you write the statement only, then organic chemistry will be easy for you, or else it will be very difficult. No one can remember the equations. Until you don't know the statement, how can you write the equation? So you have to write the statement also. So ethanol reacts with phosphorus pentachloride and gives ethyl chloride and phosphoric chloride and HCl. So what is the IUPAC name of this? Chloroethane. Chloroethane. Right? Now let us move to the next reaction. So, action with zinc chloride and HCl. Zinc chloride and HCl. Yes, by seeing this also, many of you have remembered the name of this reagent. Yes, it is Lucas reagent. What is it, Nana? Lucas reagent. So ZnCl2 plus HCl. Now, what is the reaction taking place here? Let us see. So action with zinc chloride and HCl. So ethanol, I'll go for black. So ethanol C2H5OH. Okay. So when heated with Lucas reagent, ZnCl2 plus HCl. Okay. At 60 degrees centigrade, then what happens is nothing but the elimination of water takes place here, right? So OH from here and H from here. So what do you get? You will get ethyl chloride, CH3CH2Cl, ethyl chloride and H2O. So you'll get ethyl chloride, right? So this is the reaction with Lucas reagent, zinc chloride and HCl. Okay. So again, shall I write the name or else it is okay for you? So this is chloroethane. What is it? Chloroethane. So I will write the name of this. Chloroethane. So this is the action with Lucas reagent. So now let us move to the next reaction. Okay. So please write down the notes, Nana. Then only you can remember it well. So these reactions, now we are going to learn are the dehydration reactions. See, what is it? Dehydration. What is dehydration? D means removal. Hydration means water, right? Dehydration, elimination of water. I will write here. No issues. Elimination of water. H2O. Elimination of H2O. So dehydration, removal of water. So ethanol, CH3CH2. The elimination reactions, that is the dehydration reactions, are very important now. both for your objective and for your IP. So I will write down all these reactions such that you can remember it very easily, right? So ethanol, when treated with sulfuric acid, H2SO4, at, so I will go for the other color for showing the temperature. At what temperature? 70 degrees. 70 degrees. Then what is the product you get here? So you get a product, ethyl hydrogen sulfate, CH3, CH2, H, then this is C, Nana, CH2, HSO4. So ethyl hydrogen sulfate. Okay, so let us write the name also here, right? Ethyl hydrogen sulfate. So ethyl hydrogen sulfate. See, I'm writing each and everything, Nana, because I'm not sharing any PPTs, no? See, that's why. Ethyl hydrogen sulfate. So now, let us see the other dehydration reactions. So then, the next one, when it is heated with, again, sulfuric acid. At 140 degrees, what is the temperature? Remember, 140 degrees, right? 140 degrees. Then what is the product you get here? So the product you get here is CH3, CH2O, CH2, CH3. See, what is the product? It is nothing but diethyl ether. What is the product, ma? Diethyl ether. So diethyl ether, ethoxyethane, right? Ethoxyethane, okay? So then another reaction, let us learn now. See, these are all the dehydration reactions. Elimination of water is taking place here. Please remember. Now, when it is heated with alumina, Al2O3, alumina, but the temperature is different, 250 degrees centigrade. See, what is the temperature, ma? 250 degrees centigrade. And what is the product you get here? See, when it is heated at 250 degrees centigrade in the presence of alumina, you get the same product, that is diethyl ether, CH3, CH2, O, CH2, CH3. So what is the product, ma? Diethyl ether. So please remember the conditions and the temperature, Nana. Then it will be easy. So you'll get diethyl ether, right? Okay. Right. So now let us move to the another dehydration reaction. Right. So then what is this? Let us see here. Then when it is heated with sulfuric acid. Okay. Sulfuric acid. And then note down the temperature, Nana. 170 degrees. What is the temperature? 170 degrees. And what is the product you get here? So you get ethene, that is ethylene. What is the product you get here? Ethene. I'll go for a blue color such that you can remember them in a serial order. So you get ethene, C2H4, CH2, double bond CH2. So what is the name, Nana? Ethene or ethylene. Ethene or ethylene, right? So now let us see the last reaction in this dehydration, okay? So in the dehydration, that is the elimination of water, when this is heated with alumina, the temperature is high, that is 350 degrees centigrade. And then the product which you get here is again ethene. See, I'm writing the same products. Okay, CH2 double bond, CH2. So what is the name of this? Ethene. Okay, ethene. So these are the elimination reactions. So please remember, Nana. So what are the elimination reactions? So when ethanol is heated with sulfuric acid and alumina, we get different products. At 70 degrees centigrade, it gives ethyl hydrogen sulfate, like that you can remember. Then when heated at 140 degrees centigrade, we get diethyl ether. And then when heated at 170 degrees centigrade, we get ethene. Then at 250 degrees centigrade, we get diethyl ether. And then at 350 degrees centigrade, at higher temperature, we get ethene. Okay, so these are the dehydration reactions, that is elimination of water from ethanol. So hope you have understood this, Nana. Okay, so then ethanol, okay, elimination of water, dehydration, right? So now let us move to the next property of these alcohols. Okay, so then what is this? Let us see now. So ethanol, C2H5OH, on oxidation, addition of oxygens. What is this? Addition of oxygen is called as oxidation. We can call it as removal of hydrogen also. Then oxidation in the presence of potassium dichromate, K2CR2O7. Okay, and in the presence of an acid. See, that's why I'm showing this as H plus, Nana. Okay, so ethanol on oxidation in the presence of potassium dichromate. Potassium dichromate. See, what is the product you get here? You get acetic acid. That is a carboxylic acid. See, what is it? Carboxylic acid. CH3COOH. So you get acetic acid. So by this you can understand that, so when ethanol undergoes oxidation, ethanol undergoes oxidation in the presence of potassium dichromate, it gives acetic acid, which is a carboxylic acid. Okay, so then coming to the next one, action with bleaching powder. What is bleaching powder? Calcium oxychloride and H2O. Right? So what is the reaction? Let us see here. So ethanol, C2H5OH. Okay. So plus calcium oxychloride and water. So you get chloroform. What do you get? Chloroform, CHCl3 and calcium formate. What do you get? Calcium formate, Ca, okay, HCOO, and then HCOO. Like this also we can write, Nana. Ca, H, C, this is C, Nana, O, taken twice. Understood? So what is the name of this? Calcium formate. Calcium formate. Okay, I will write the names. Chloroform. Calcium oxychloride. I'm not leaving any single compound or simple compound also without naming it. So please try to remember calcium oxychloride. Right? So this is the action with calcium oxychloride and water. That is a bleaching powder. Nothing but bleaching powder. Okay. So now let us move to the next reaction. So this is dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen, right? Removal of hydrogen. And then when ethanol, C2H5OH, ethanol is heated with copper at 300 degrees centigrade. See, copper is a catalyst. So when you heat this with the copper at 300 degrees centigrade, it undergoes dehydrogenation, Nana. So removal of hydrogen takes place. Then if removal of hydrogen takes place, means what is the compound you get here? You get acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, acetaldehyde. Okay, so I will write the name of this. So this is ethanol, aldehyde, and this is ethanol, ol, alcohol. So this is ethanol and this is ethanol. So this reaction is dehydrogenation, removal of hydrogen. I will write here. Removal of, okay. So removal of hydrogen. Clear? Right. So then we will move to the, so just two more properties are left here. After that, we can move to the another topic tomorrow. Means in my next session, children. See, that's why I'm taking a few more minutes. Then, so the next reaction is action with. Okay. Sodium hydroxide and iodine. So this is a very important name reaction called as iodoform reaction. What reaction? Iodoform reaction. Iodoform reaction. So please remember this iodoform reaction. So ethanol C2H5OH. So reacts with sodium hydroxide, okay, and iodine. Then what does it forms? It forms iodoform. What is CHCl3? Chloroform. And what is CHI3? Iodoform. Iodoform. Iodoform and sodium formate, HCOONA. What is it? Sodium formate. Sodium formate. So this is called as iodoform reaction. So in this, the primary alcohols will convert into iodoform. So this is sodium formate. What is this? Sodium formate. Sodium formate. Okay. So ethanol reacts with sodium hydroxide in the presence of iodine and forms iodoform and sodium formate, right? Sodium formate. Okay, so then the next one is action with hydrogen iodide in the presence of phosphorus. In the presence of phosphorus. So here, ethanol, when treated with hydrogen iodide in the presence of phosphorus, it gives ethane. What does it give? Ethane. CH3, CH3. So ethane. Right? So then, next, so ethanol C2H5OH plus nitric acid HNO3 gives nitroethane. What does it give? Nitroethane C2H5, okay, NO2, nitroethane. Okay. So I hope you have understood this, right? So then action with the HI in the presence of phosphorus gives ethane, right? So then when ethyl alcohol is heated with nitric acid, what does it give? So it gives nitroethane. What does it give? Nitroethane. Okay. So and then please remember this iodoform reaction. And this is also called as a haloform reaction also. Haloform. What are halogens? The 7A group elements are called as halogens. Haloform reaction. Haloform reaction. Haloform reaction. So ethanol, when treated with sodium hydroxide in the presence of iodine, gives iodoform and then sodium formate. Okay, so then you will get sodium iodide and other byproducts also, but the major one is the iodo form, which you have to remember. And this reaction is given by the primary alcohols. Here you have to remember that the compounds which contains the methyl ketone group. So like this, so then they give the iodo form reaction. Okay, so the halogen in the presence of a base gives iodo form, and this is called as iodo form reaction. Okay, so then let us recall the topics which we have learned today, children. So today I have discussed about the commercial methods of preparations of alcohols and then the properties of alcohols. Then in the commercial methods of preparation, I have explained you the fermentation of molasses, right? So how ethanol is prepared on large scale by the fermentation of molasses. Molasses is the mother liquor which is left after the crystallization of sugar from sugarcane. And fermentation is a process in which the large complex organic compound is broken into simpler compounds. Okay, so it is diluted with water such that the level of sugar comes down to 10%. Sulfuric acid is added. The pH is maintained at 4. Ammonium sulfate and ammonium phosphate are added, which acts as food for yeast. Okay, then it is kept for 2 to 3 days at 30 to 40 degrees centigrade. Then the yeast cells produces 2 enzymes. That's why I call it as biocatalyst. Remember, please remember. See, bio means having life. Yeast cells will have some life. Yeast cells are living organisms, isn't it? As they are producing the catalyst and these are acting here, that's why we call as biocatalyst. Okay, so invertase acts on sucrose and converts it into glucose and fructose. Zymase acts on glucose and converts it into ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide is liberated. Okay, so thank you, Shailaja ma'am. So in my next session, I will revise the properties once again, ma'am. Shailaja ma'am. Shailaja ma'am. So we discussed about the properties of alcohols also, right? Like why alcohols are soluble in water, because they have intermolecular hydrogen bonding with water. So then I discussed about the reactions which involve the cleavage of OH bond, okay? And then we discussed the reaction with active metals. It shows that alcohols are acidic in nature. Okay, children, right? So then we discussed about the esterification, means the formation of ester, right? So ethanol reacts with ethanoic acid and then forms ethyl acetate, which is an ester. And ethanol reacts with acetyl chloride and forms ethyl acetate, which is also an ester. And these two reactions are the esterification reactions where an ester is obtained. Shailja ma'am. Ma'am, my session is
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. You have covered the properties and the commercial preparation of.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. I have taken extra time, I think, ma'am, today.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. But it was comprehensive. Dear children, please once again revisit this session and prepare the notes. The important reactions. Please make a note of all the reactions. Practice very well. Organic reactions have to be practiced properly, once and twice. Thank you, madam. Thank you for
Thank
the
you,
education.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Thank you for the opportunity given to me.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.